Good morning, everybody. I never did get to do that fun dog show video, although I actually did video the show, which might not be that fun, but it was extremely exciting for us. And we also won super big the next day. Interestingly, even though we got a group two from the judge, we didn't win the breed the next day. There were some psychological things going on, and it's actually super, super sad, but the better you do in your breed, the less friends you have in the breed. That's the dark side of that sport, which really Al hates because he just can't stand seeing things like that. But I'm so grateful for all my friends. There are some definite friends still in the breed, and those that are not in the breed, I'm super grateful for. And I'm just, every time someone does something really mean, I just learn that it gives me more inspiration to do great. So anyway, Asher, the next day, he still got select, which is great because there were like 8 champions out of 19 dogs. And then best opposite went to Emma, and Willow got select. So we were still doing awesome. The only difference was Griffey didn't get winner's dog, and Asher, instead of getting breed, got the select award, but it was still huge. Anyway, I had wanted to do a video for everybody talking more about some pointers for living with multiple dogs. So I'm not super organized this morning, but I'll talk about a few of them. One is what you're seeing right here. I tend, because female terriers are the ones you really need to worry about as far as fighting. Even when I had the unneutered Obi and Asher, I worried less than girl issues. So I'm bonding these three up as much as possible. And still, Willow has been unbelievable with Daisy. And on that front too, I'll report that she still wants to kill all the little puppies at the shows. But Griffey, her puppy from the first litter, she didn't even give the time of day to. And she's getting better with Emma, who's now, almost 18 months of age. So it's real interesting. I think that might just be nature's way of saying, don't come back here. When they're real young is when she wants to get them. And of course, she's fine with Daisy. Also a quick update on the cat. It looks like I might not get to the multiple dog pointers this time. Cheery has been staying away lately at night, and it's killing us to try to get her back in. Like, she'll start jumping out of my arms. She's not freaked out, though, once she gets in. And the dogs are being great with her. When Hal did admit that Willow went after her when Lexi and I weren't there, and he, I believe him too, he said he's extremely disciplined Willow, and then made a point of bringing the cat to each Willow and Cheery, or Willow and Daisy, and letting her see them. So that was good. So they're kind of ignoring her, but by choice, she's not wanting to be around them as much. She just is. I really wish in retrospect that we got a male cat, because she's just that way. So anyway, I hope she's okay. I'm struggling with what to do, because if we leave her out at night with her bell collar on, which we have to prevent her from getting the birds, then I just feel like she's more vulnerable to coyotes. So anyway, back to my pointers. And if you have any ideas, let me know. But I mean, I'm honestly not sure what to do, because I don't want to lose Cheery, but I can't every single day go through this. Like yesterday, when I tried to bring her in, she jumped out of my arms again. And the day before, I had to hold her by the scruff of her neck to bring her in. I probably could have done that yesterday, but it's just getting tiring. And it's like, okay, if you want to stay out, we leave the garage open. She has all sorts of access, but there are coyotes. So anyway, so one of my pointers is trying on purpose to keep the girls together and do things together, increase bonding. Other pointers, though, is like, well, I don't leave them alone together, the girls, anymore. Sometimes I will still leave Shaq and Willow, and if it's a real brief time or in a hotel room, I'll leave Daisy. And I left Daisy and Willow for 5 hours when we were at the show with Asher the other day, because I knew they were in the hotel room. So when you know the risk is almost zero because they're tired and they really are almost needing each other for security, then is your time to do it, because it strengthens the practice of being together without issues. Let's see, other issues, other things I guess I'll talk about for sure with multiple dogs is that I really do believe dogs keep score. So you have to try to be treating everybody as equal as possible. Although we always make an exception, sorry, I'm going up a huge hill again, for seniors. And seniors I do give, like Shaq, she's not the natural alpha, it's probably Willow, but it doesn't matter because we let Shaq get fed first and then we put the other dogs in the other rooms. So that's very helpful. This way, guys, I'm trying to think right now just in specific about my multiple dog pointers. This way, everybody, because a lot of them are just the same as good dog management, but draining energy always, which again is good dog management, but I think that the thing is I'm doing better usually with my spontaneous videos. My organized pointers aren't that great, but the other things that we do is we treat them completely equal and transitions. That's huge. I may have talked about that before, but when we take two dogs away to a show and we come back, like I say, they're keeping score. So I'll very strategically then say, if Asher and Daisy have been away at a show, then the next day, I often will walk Willow with Daisy, just in this case, because Willow's been so alpha with the puppies, I want to rebond them. But the typical mode would be to take the two dogs first that haven't been at the show. And when we do get home again, we always monitor energy and we never, ever let them all together all at once. That's just hopefully common sense. We let the two dogs that have been away get the smell of the yard, let the other dogs see them from inside, and then strategically rotate like one dog with another. So always paying attention to transition and just, you know, overall awareness of energy in the house is something I've really had to increase, because I tend to be kind of a freedom person. That's why we don't have a lot of crates. And I've learned that, you know what, dogs don't always need that much total freedom. These guys get walked all the time, so now we don't let all five out in the yard all at once. I think four would be a way easier, better number, and I was often still letting four out in the yard, but I was still even watching then. But with five, I just don't. I just think that it's just too much potential for something to happen. And that's another great pointer. I'm sure you all know this, but we're very lucky to not have, for the most part, dogs in the neighborhood running loose on the fence. But when they do, you always want to get your dogs in, because I've seen so many dogs that get inspired to fight each other because of the energy. Oh, here's Rose Shack. She's all tangled in the lead happening on the outside of the fence. Hey, good girls. Everyone a little goody? So that's some pointers for you too. Stay, wait. Here. Good girl. I know I have a lot more and I'm not really thinking of them right now, so if I can think of them later and post them, I will. But I just wanted to do this quick video for everybody, more to give an update too. All right, see ya. Say bye bye, girls. All right.